Welcome to another TMS software hands-on tutorial. Today I'm going to introduce you again to the TWebChatbox control, which was introduced in TMS WEB Core version 1.8 Cirolo. The example is a little bit tricky to set up because you have a server project and a client project. Both parts communicate through WebSockets, which on the other hand makes it a great example again to explain and further look into WebSockets. Let's start by looking for the demonstration where we find it on the hard disk. In your Web Core demo folder, there is basics, and then there is the chatbox directory. And there you have two projects. One is the server project, and the other one is the actual chat client web application that you can access multiple times for multiple users or to simulate multiple users. The server project, if you open it up, is not a web project, it is a VCL project, but if you open up the main form, you might think it is not a form, it is a data module of type T chat service, and at this moment, you should realize it is a service application, a Windows service, derived from the class T service. That's how Windows services are modeled in Delphi. That means if you compile this project, you end up with a server.exe, but if you start it in the IDE, nothing seems to happen. And the reason for that is service applications become executables that have to be used with two parameters. The one parameter is install to install the service and uninstall to uninstall the service from Windows. So in order to go ahead with this, we right-click the project and would say show in Explorer. And there you see the server exe that has been created. However, we need admin privileges in order to install this, and we need to call it from the command line. So I open a PowerShell with admin privileges in this folder. You could also use Windows Terminal. The key is you need admin privileges, because if you don't, let's do it like this. This is Windows Terminal, so server.exe. Nothing seems to happen. You need to know which parameters to use. So we have to, for example, use install. And the message that we're going to get is access is denied. You need admin privileges. There's no way around that. We go leave this window, right click here, open PowerShell as administrator, confirm. And here we have the right directory. Once again, we say server.exe. /install, that is the command to install the service into Windows, uninstall to uninstall the service. Where do you find the services? Of course, in the Windows Services app. Let's look at the Services window. And if you go to C, there is nothing there, but where do you find the service in the Services window? So looking at the application again, on the data module, looking in the object inspector, you see the display name for the service. This is the display name the service will use, and the name is chat service. Be aware that this name has to be unique on your system. So sometimes you get something like TMS chat service or my company name chat service as the name, and the display name is something that the user can actually comprehend. So be aware that the chat service has to be unique on your system, which probably is the case, and the display name is what the user sees. Also, you can configure stuff like if it starts automatically, manually, if you allow it to stop, to pause, and so on. And the events also have to be implemented. That is what we're going to look at a little bit later. Let's install it first. So going back here, server exe, install. And this time we get the message service installed successfully because we have admin privileges. We click OK. We open up the service window again and press F5. And there it is, chat service. Double click. You also see TMS Web Core demo basic chatbox server.exe. Everything is set up, but it is not started yet. So I click start the service. And that's all it takes for you to use the demonstration from TMS. The web client is now able to connect to the service and you can simulate your chat sessions. However, let's look at the service or server in more detail. What is going on? When the service starts, we start a TTMS WebSocket server, and whenever a message is received, we hook that to the message received, and we set the server to active. That's it. And the internal state of the service has to be set to true as well. When the service stops, we simply free and null the instance of the TMS WebSocket server. What happens if a message is being received? This is something you find here. We simply broadcast the message, which is a method on the TCP server, to all clients. Of course, you have other exciting things that you can do on the server. Let's see. You can not only broadcast the message, you can also broadcast data. You, of course, have implementation for SSL, for certificates, and that will allow you to send data to all the connected clients very easily. So it might look pretty complicated at first. All this here is being produced by the template that Delphi provides for us. So if you ever want to build your own service, own server, you can simply go to File, New, Other, and then in Delphi, go to the Windows folder, and there you find the Windows service. That's the template that you can use. The only tricky part is you always end up with a console application, even though everything seems to be VCL, but you end up with a console application and the two parameters, install and uninstall, are fixed. So let's look at the web client. We open the project. We open the TMS web chat client. Okay. We don't want to save any changes. And the client uses primarily the chatbox, which is supposed to be demonstrated. We have a web edit control for the name of the user, and we can connect to the server. And the WebSocket client is what connects to the WebSocket server that runs in the service. And as we want to keep things simple, we use the default port of 888. So whenever we connect, we simply, if we're already connected, we disconnect. Otherwise, we call the connect method on the client. And as I already explained, the client uses the standard port 8888. You can configure that differently. Just be aware, then you also have to make the change from the default port on the server as well. Also, when we connect, we set the username of the chatbox to the username that was specified, and the outgoing bubble color is being set to the color selected with the color picker, another great control that was introduced to TMS Web Core recently. The socket client, of course, has to implement a method. What happens when we connect? What happens when data is being received? And what happens on disconnect? Disconnect literally will change some of the user interface elements, and data received is the event that will have to make changes to the chatbox. However, before we can look how the data is being received, we actually have to look how we send the data, because then we know how to parse the information that has been sent from the other side. And this is also something that is a little bit difficult to understand at first. Of course, the client, the web client, implements the sending and the receiving at the same time, because if another client sends something, this client has to receive it. And if this client receives something, it was sent by another client before. So that might be a little bit confusing at first, but both sides have to be implemented using the same encoding for the message. That's the key part here. You can use strings to keep it simple. If you want to send additional information, of course, you can do that. You just have to make sure that the packages that you send can be parsed easily and displayed again by your TMS Web Core application. Of course, you also have to set the host name of your chat server. So we set this to this machine. And let's see, as we have started the service, if it works at this time. So let's start it. Okay, so this will be Holger. I take the color yellow. We connect. This is being disabled. And the change is the button caption from connect to disconnect. And we open a second client right here. We have to just do a little bit of alignment here on the small resolution when I do the recording. And we go to the same URL as here. Boom. And we select a different color. This is all implemented in the color picker control, so no implementation needed. Nice blue, Bruno, connect. So now we have two people connected to the chat service running on this computer. And Holger is now saying, hi, Bruno, enter. And you see it's, of course, because it's a broadcast, it's automatically being shown on both sides. And Bruno says, hi, Holger. And same thing happening, what is being broadcast appears on both sides. And because we use here now a IP address like this, of course, this would only work in the internal network in the 192.168.0 subnet. It wouldn't work over their internet. If you specify a domain name or something like that, this would work over the internet as well, of course, given that the port 8888 is also available. Let's look at the final part, how are messages actually being sent and received. The sending you find in the chat box. The chat box has an event on send message, and there you see what is happening. First of all, the color is being converted to an HTML string. That is the first part of the message. And then we use this wonderful, I think the term is tilde sign. Then we encode the username and another tilde sign. We have the chat message. Of course, if the chat message were to include the tilde sign, it will no longer work. So this is really demo character. So you can't use the tilde sign in any of your messages right now. And then you simply send the string S to the server. There is a size limitation of 255 characters for the whole message. Note that the message is being given to you as a type T message, so you can look at value dot to inspect the type, and you see that you have the color, the chat message, you have the sender, the timestamp, the avatar, and all that stuff. So probably in a real world application you would also encode all that so that the other side is able to display it appropriately. On the receiving end, you won't find that in the chat box, you'll find that on the client, on the WebSocket client. So when data is received, you do the reverse. You take the data, which is being supplied as a JS object, convert it into a string, create a string list, and make the tilde sign, the delimiter, and then you can simply access all the different elements of the message using delimited text. And then you create a new tmessage object and add it to the chatbox. That's what is being done. So you add a new message to the chatbox. The chat message is at position number 3, index 2. The sender is at position number 2, index 1. And the color is at position number 1, index 0. And if you're struggling to remember which index is where, you can always go back to the send message, and then you can see that the color is first, then the username, then the chat message, color, user, and chat message. So that is how easy it is to implement a chat using WebSockets with TMS Web Core and the controls that are bundled inside of the product. One final piece of the puzzle is still missing. How do you uninstall the service from a Windows operating system? You simply call uninstall. So instead of install, you call uninstall. The thing to remember is if the service is still running, which is the case right now, it will not be removed before you stop it. Windows is that smart. So let's say it is still running, you call uninstall. This message says, hey, I uninstalled it successfully. If you go over to the services app, press F5, it's still there. If you stop it, that moment it will also disappear because Windows marks it for deletion. It's also a different state that a service can have marked for deletion. And as soon as you stop it, it's getting deleted. So that's how you clean up your operating system after using this demo. I hope you liked this first glimpse at WebSockets in usage in conjunction with the TWeb Chatbox. For more detailed information and a trial version of the product, go to web.tmssoftware.com or browse our YouTube channel for more hands-on tutorials.